We will start today's wonderful problem with a square with the side of 20. Then, on the bottom side of our square, we will construct two identical semicircles whose diameter is expanding along the bottom side of the square, as you can see on the sketch. Next, in the upper segment of the square, we will inscribe the biggest possible circle that touches the upper side of the square, and it also touches our two bottom semicircles. Now, the question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this big red circle? I found this problem in one of the math books, and I wanted to share with you guys because I think that it is a wonderful problem. And of course, you guys can pause the video right now if you want to tackle this problem. If not, then stick around because we're going to solve it together. All right, so let's solve this problem. So first, for the better understanding, I'm going to label all the vertices of our square as A, B, C, and D, and I will label the center of our inner circle as O. Then, let's have a look at our two semicircles on the bottom. We know that both diameters of the semicircles expand along the bottom side of the square, which equals to 20. And since those two semicircles are identical, this means that those diameters must have the length of 10. Now, let's focus only on the semicircle on the right. We can label the center of the semicircle as P and the left vertice as Q. This point is also the midpoint of our bottom side of the square. Now, since the diameter of our semicircle is equal to 10, this means that its radius is equal to 5, so the lines PB and PQ are equal to 5. Now, let's label the radius of our big circle as R. And let's rotate this radius vertically up, as you can see on the sketch. Now, we will expand the line of this radius vertically down from point O to point Q. And if we take a look at the left side of our square, we can see that it has the length of 20. Now, if we simplify our image a little bit and slide this side to the right, you can see that this side has the length which equals to the sum of the lengths of blue and red line. So this means that the length of the blue line must be equal to 20 minus R. Alright, so now let's focus only on our big circle and our small semicircle on the right. And let's notice the radius of this small semicircle. Then we can rotate this radius to the point of tangency or the intersection point between our two circles, if you like. We can do the same for the radius of our big circle. If we do this, we will get the straight line OP. We know for the fact that this is a straight line by using one really interesting theorem of a circle, which states that if two circles touch each other externally or internally, then their point of contact lies on a straight line joining their centers. And as you can see, this is exactly our case, since the line OP connects two centers of our circles and it passes through their point of contact. And we can also say that the line OP has the length which equals to the sum of both radii of those two circles, which equals to R plus 5. Now, let's go back to our original sketch. And let's notice that the line OQ is a vertical line and AB is horizontal line. So this means that the angle at the point Q must be right angle. Now we can notice one really interesting right angle triangle PQO, and we can write the Pythagorean theorem. We can say that hypotenuse OP squared is equal to the leg QP squared plus the leg OQ squared, and we can of course substitute the values for those lines from our sketch. Now we can continue on by expanding the left and right side of this equation by using the square of binomial. If we do this, we will get the following. Now we can simplify a little bit by first cancelling r squared on the both sides of the equation, and we can also cancel 25 on both sides of the equation as well, since those values have the same sign and they are located on the opposite side of the equation. Now we can group the unknowns on the left side of the equation, and we can calculate to get that 50r is equal to 400, which means that r must be equal to 8. Now, remember, we're looking for the area of the red circle, and the area equals to pi r squared. So we can just substitute the value of r and get that that is 8 squared pi, which means that the area of our red circle equals to 64 pi, and this is our wonderful solution. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this really cute problem, and if you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel. Those stuff truly means a lot to me to continue on with making this kind of videos. And of course, if you guys found any other way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section as you always do. And until next time, see you all and take care.